On behalf of School of Agriculture, I welcome all of you. Today we are going to discuss about the production of value-added products from fruits and vegetables. We have with one our expert, Dr. D.S. Khurdia, who retired as head of department of the post-harvest technology from IRI, who is with us for development of the program. So I will request him to give more details that what is this, why there is a need for this type of program, and what is the post-harvest and the scope in this area. Dr. Khurdia, please.
Thank you, Dr. Saluja. As you know, the fruit and vegetables is a very perishable commodity. I mean, the horticulture produce, some are the dried products, some of the fruits, vegetables, spices, so many things. But especially the fruit and vegetables were highly perishable because of the moisture content. India produces about 137.5 million tons of fruit and vegetables, out of which fruit is about 47.5 and vegetable is 90 million tons per annum. Out of these total produce, hardly we are processing less than 2%. Means in other countries you will find they are producing some in Brazil 70%, USA 60 to 70%, Malaysia 83%, and our processing is very meager. Until unless we process a larger quantum of the fruit and vegetables, we cannot preserve it for longer durations. As you will find, there after the harvest, handling, then storage, then bringing to it to the consumers, we will find about 20 to 30% of this produce is being lost, either by spoilage, by microorganisms, by chemical changes, because most of the people do not know how to handle this fresh fruit and commodities. As you know that any person stand in the sun and he get the effect of the sun also. Similarly, the fruit and vegetables you will find the vendors which are keeping in the sun, the fruit and vegetables lost also. So loss and spoilage, if we can protect, we can provide the supply without producing much of the fruit and vegetables. So that is the basic things here. In order to do that one, and most of the times you will find nowadays we have to be export to WTO or globalizations, so we have to produce a good quality material, and for this purpose the food processing is a essential indispensable need at the present to process the fruit and vegetables. And that's why the School of Agriculture has proposed a certificate and diploma course on the production of the value-added product from the fruit and vegetables. Dr. Saluja, you have told about the School of Agriculture. Can you elaborate something more about the scope and job and objectives also, so that we can further discuss about the this diploma program?
This program is primarily meant for the developing the technician in the sector. The program is meant for developing the technician and entrepreneurship for the program. Now, what are the areas, if we see the scope of the program, what is the areas which we are covering is the preparation of value added products, then cleanliness, handling of the products, proper cleaning of the equipment. These are the broad areas which we will be covering into the course. The nature of the jobs which we are expecting is there will be the procurement assistant could be there, field assistant, graders at mandis, primary processing unit, processing technician, junior plant operator, storage technician, salesman, village extension worker, and under the self-employment could be the procurer, small scale food processing entrepreneur or trainer. This course is mainly focusing on the two things. First is how to control the post harvest losses, and second to develop some of the value added products from the fruit and vegetables. As Dr. Khurdia has explained that we are only processing around 1 to 2% of the fruit and vegetable production. And our target is to have around 10% of the fruit and vegetable processing sector. So when the sector will be increasing, naturally we need the manpower. Manpower who are properly trained into the system. At present, there is a very few institutions, those who are training the food technologist or even the technician in the program. In the school level also, the food technology is not an independent subject, and the institutions at higher level also, food technology is not taught. So the average student pass out from the different institutions is very less. And if you see any plant of around 5 lakh rupees investment, capital investment, he needs around 5 to 6 technician is there. In our country, we are having around 6,000 plants, but it is assumed that as the processing sector will grow around 10%, we are going to have around 500 to 600 units on average 1 to 2 years. So we can assume that in every year, we are going to add around 2,000 to 3,000 of technician will be required into the country. And in our system, in education system, there is no system which is preparing this manpower. So that's why the objective was to take the diploma program, which will be focusing on the development of entrepreneurship and the technician. So this, it will also add, what will be the other advantages associated with this will be the, now we are telling that agriculture needs the diversification into different types of program. So this program will also strengthen the diversification and commercialization of agriculture. It will also help in developing the appropriate technologies at the production center, that is at the village level, we can have the processing of the surplus fruits and vegetables in that particular area. They will be processed and then they can be marketed into the nearby urban areas. The shelf life will be more, and the post-harvest losses, which is around 20 to 30%, could be reduced is there. This will also promote entrepreneurship, employment at the rural level. It will also help in the promotion of export, and capacity utilization of the existing industries would also be helpful. Many of the plants at the present, they are working on the seasonal basis. So these, if we have the post-harvest losses could be controlled, these plants will be able to get the raw material and the capacity utilization would be better. So this is the scope of the program is there. So if you see the objectives, what are the objectives of this program is, the objective is to improve the knowledge and technical proficiency of the students in the procurement of raw materials, then preparation of value added products, prevention of losses in fresh and processed horticulture produce, marketing and economical aspects, then managing small and medium enterprises. So these are the objectives that this course will be able to impart: knowledge and technical proficiency in procurement of raw materials, preparation of a range of value added products, prevention of losses in fresh and processed horticulture produce, and then marketing and economical aspects will be there. These type of manpower will be aiming to reduce the post-harvest losses, and they will be developed as young entrepreneurs for preparation of a range of value added fruits and vegetables will be there. So these are the needs and scope and the job potential of the program. Now I will request Dr. Khurdia to give more about the type of program and its structure.
Thank you, Dr. Saluja. We have this program for certificate course also, as well as diploma course also. So as per the IGNU norm, the certificate courses, we have about 4 courses, and for the diploma program, we have 8 courses. 8 courses, and they are the covering the on the allied as well as the post-harvest management of the fruit and vegetables also. The course 1 deals with the fundamentals of food fundamentals. Second is principles of post-harvest management of horticulture crop produce. Third is food chemistry and physiology. fourth is a food processing and engineering one, fifth is food microbiology, sixth is food processing and engineering two, and seventh is food quality testing and evaluation, and eighth is entrepreneurship and marketing. So the development of a student having these certificate courses, we can do in covering 6 months, and those who have a diploma course, they cover about 1 year. So they develop a skill how to produce the process products, know about the chemistry, the physiology, how it behaves during the storage, how they are processed, and after the processing, what is the packaging, what is the quality aspect, and how it can be marketing as an entrepreneurship. So the person who undergoing this diploma course can obtain the knowledge and the skillful job preparations, so he can be a self-employed, or he can start your own employment and provide the employment, regenerate employment to the others also. So now we can discuss these courses in little bit of details, so we can you can know that what are the subject is generally covered under this one. So I will request Dr. Saluja to tell about the what fundamentals, food fundamentals, tells about this, what are the subject are governed under this food fundamental course.
Thank you, Dr. Khurdia. Like, this program is a modular type of program. Student will get a certificate if he completes 6 months, and it will be of 16 credits, and diploma is for the 32 credits are there. The entry requirement for this program is 10 plus 2 level. Any rural youth or any youth who is 10 plus 2 with science stream is eligible for this program. He should be secondary pass out. Even the IGNO BPP students are also eligible for this program. This is a competency based program, that the focus is there to development of competences. Before going into the courses, I will tell what type of competences are being developed. As I mentioned, in certificate program, the focus will be on to the post-harvest management and primary processing of horticulture produce. Like, what type of competences? He should be able to identify and characterize important fruit and vegetables in his area. That what are the fruits and vegetables which has economic importance or nutritional importance, or could be value added into this. The second competencies which will be developed is quality assessment through physical and sensory method. The student will be trained that they will be able to assess the quality assessment through physical and sensory methods. Then what are the adulterants, foreign and undesirable adulterants? The important thing is maturity indexes for these fruits and vegetables. Sometimes we see in the market the fruits are unripened, are they are overripened. So what is the maturity indices for these fruits and vegetables? Then you will be able to identify what are the common physical and discoloration defects into the products. Then how to control the quality through harvesting factors. And during the harvesting stage also, some of the defects into the products could be reduced. Then what are the identification of causes for post-harvest losses? Then how to control the perishability losses, then packaging of fruits for the raw transportation, how the transportation of fresh produce could be done, the losses could be controlled is there. Then the primary post-harvest treatment which could be done at the farm level, like cleaning, selection, grading, packing, then curing. These competencies will be also developed into this. The students will be also trained that how to construct and maintain the storage structures at the village level or at the town level. Then the storage temperatures, how to control them. Then also to develop a marketable, the important point is to operate a market information system, that from his place where he should go for the marketing of his product. Nowadays, many of the information is available through the cell phone and through the internet also, through the net, that what are the primary rates of the mandis, so that a farmer could go to the different nearby mandis and sell his product at a higher rates are there. So these are the competencies which will be focused at the certificate level, that is post harvest management and the primary processing. At the diploma level, the focus will be on the development of new type of products, like is one is identification of raw materials and what is their quality parameters will be there. If he is working in the plant, he is able to define that what type of raw material he wants. Then primary knowledge about the equipment and the primary processing unit, then preparation of raw material, cleaning, grading, washing, then preparation of the value added products, their production and storage, preparation of byproducts, preparation of value added byproducts, operation and maintenance of equipment and machinery, cleaning and sanitization of plant equipment, setting up of plants, identification of minor defects and their corrections, distribution of labor for a batch, processing cost, how much it cost, control of operation losses, maintenance of records and log books. So these are the competencies which will be developed into this. Keeping this into the account, we have developed the different programs. Now these competencies we have identified from the industry people. When we interacted with the different industry people, they said that these are the requirements for a technician level or for an entrepreneur. So after discussing with them, we thought that these could be the 8 courses could be we need, and that's why the 8 courses have been identified. Now as Dr. Khodi has explained, the first course is Fundamentals of Food Science is there. Now it consists of 4 blocks. It gives to the basic to the concept about the food science. And the so first is Introduction to Food Science and Technology, one block is there. Then the characteristics of edible agriculture produce, then nutritional aspects and the quality aspect. These are the 4 blocks, and they cover the all the basic elementary knowledge about the food science, that what are the components of food science, like it consists of food grains, oil seeds, fruits and vegetables, dairy, poultry, fisheries and the commercial crop. And the next plant goes to the nutritional aspects are also covered, that what is the importance of food and in our daily diet, and how much is the loss of food values takes place into the fresh food and the processed products, what are the anti-nutritional factors is there. There is also in the introduction course, what are the food processing industries, what are the food laws, these will be also introduced into the aspects. Nowadays for particularly export and other things, quality aspects has been taken important. So what are the quality characteristics, what are the factors which deteriorate the quality, what are the quality assurance regulations, so those aspects will be also covered into the courses. So this food fundamentals gives the basic course to the food science to the 10+2 level courses. Now I will request Dr. Khodia to give more details about the next course. Dr. Khodia, please.
This course 2, next course, the principle of post harvest management of horticulture produce. Here we are again have 4 blocks which entitled as need and importance, post harvest treatment, storage and marketing, processing and preservation at farm levels, where the student can learn here the importance of the post harvest management, what are the post harvest losses occurring, what are the causes of these losses, how the maturity and harvesting parameters are considered to have a good quality produce. Then these fruit and vegetables are packed properly and transported to the either cold storage or to the primary market or secondary market or to the processing industries also. And then the post harvest treatments, they include the cleaning, selection, packaging. About all the treatments before packaging, they are being considered here. And then other treatments to curing, especially the root vegetables, so their skins are thick and they can have a prolonged shelf life. Sometimes the fungicide applications are also being given in order to protect it for longer shelf life also. Then after giving this all post harvest treatment and packaging, they are stored. So what are the factors that affect the storage life, then storage structures, with a different storage structure at farm level or in the market level, or in the wholesale mandi or apni mandi, the storage structures are considered in order to keep this perishable fresh fruit and vegetables for quite a long time. Then it's a marketing. What are the marketing mechanisms? How they are marketed the fresh fruit vegetables, either in the retail pack or in the wholesale pack. Then marketing information system, which we can also consider, which is very important in order to provide the all the information necessary from the producer till they reach into the hands of the consumer. So a concept system approach is being prepared in order to have the quality produce, because the what the consumer paying, they depend upon the what the grower is producing, the quality of the produce. Those are fruit and vegetables which cannot be put in the fresh market, or cult type of fruits which are little bit injured or cannot be stored. They can go for processing and preservation also. Their primary processing, the minimal processing, the latest modern approach is there. So in the supermarket or big market or departmental store, minimally processed, because it is highly perishable, but at maintaining the proper CS storage or temperature and relative humidity, they can be kept at least about 3 to 4 weeks, and in a fresh form, fresh like fruit and vegetables, and they can be sold there also. Then what are the heat application, how they are preserved, drying and dehydration in form of frozen products and by chemical additives, all sort of things will be considered under this course. Now I'll request Dr. Saluja to tell about little bit food chemistry and physiology also, these things.
Thank you, Dr. Khuria. The next course is food chemistry and physiology theory. Now we know the food chemistry primarily deals with the basic composition, structure, properties of food and the chemistry of changes during processing and utilization. Now this course will give the, it has the blocks like introduction to food chemistry and food physiology, then food constituents, food physiology, food fermentation. Because in the fruits and vegetables, the importance, particularly the role of the carbohydrates and lipids, proteins, enzymes and water, and even the minor constituents like vitamin and mineral play an important role. So it will be covering about the food constituents, what are the food constituents, then food additives will be also covered. Food physiology covers the what are the, how the ethylene liberation takes place, how the growth of the fruit takes place, then physiological disorder also. The other thing is food fermentation block, which is very important. Fermentation, that what is the methods of fermentation, its industrial significance, what are the commercial application of fruit and vegetable fermentations, what are the fruit based alcoholic beverages and the technological aspect of industrial production of alcoholic beverages. So these are the aspects which will be coming into the food chemistry, because the in the food preservation, the enzymes, the inactivation of enzymes is also an important point. The presence of enzymes or microorganisms, they act onto the food constituents and then spoil them. Sometimes the bitter taste we get because of the reactions of the enzymes onto these food constituents. So some of the defects and the shelf life of the products depends upon the composition of the food structure. So the knowledge about the food chemistry and physiology is very important, particularly for the fruit and vegetables products. That's why this course has been kept, so that the students are able to understand that what are the chemistry of changes occurring during processing and utilization of fruits and vegetables. Now I will request Dr. Khuria to give more details about the course number 4.
This course number 4 is about food processing and engineering, where the student will learn about the how to process and what are the engineering aspect also, some of the aspects. That is a block 1 in the introduction. They are learning the unit operations about moisture content, the cleaning, grading and storage. Block 2, which deals about the unit operation on milling, size reduction, material handling and transportations. So they can understand the various mechanism, engineering aspect of the food processing, how to reduce the size, how to pulp them, how to make very fine particles, they mill them, then material handling, how to handle this material through the equipment and machines, then transportation and packaging, which is very essential important aspect of the food processing. Then the block third, which deal with the value added products from food and vegetables. There are several various products made like just like a juices and beverages, different type of beverages, squashes, cordials, like that also. Then another aspect is the jam, jelly, preserve, which are preserved by the high sugar and high acid content and have a shelf life of about a year or so. Then pickle and chutneys and tomatoes and products. Pickle is a generally made household throughout the whole country, and the other type of pickles has come in the market. This is a taste and liking by the people. That's why different type of product of pickle, chutneys, tomato, so many recipes are available under this course. Then dehydrated products, how the product to dehydrate in order to reduce their volume and remove the moisture content so they can be kept for longer duration. If they properly packed, they can be kept for longer, so dehydrated products will be considered here also. Then another block, that's fourth block, that is a plant layout and mechanizations. How the processing plant is site is selected and layout is made, what are the equipment and machinery required, depend upon the processing and the products, and plant sanitation and effluent treatment, which is a basic essential of the engineering aspect, that will also be taken up under these units also. Now we'll go on to the next course, and I request Dr. Saluja to tell about the course number 5, which deals about the food microbiology also.
The one of the courses food microbiology. Now we know about the microorganisms. The microorganisms are very good also, and they are very bad also. But when it comes to the food preservation, we normally see that the microorganisms presence should be minimum. So this course, because the students are 10+2 level, so what we thought was that one course should be, one block should be an introduction, that how, what is the classification of microorganisms, what are the factors which affect the growth of the microorganisms, what is the industrial importance, then spoilage and associated problems in the food due to the microorganisms presence. So this course will be, this block will deal with the introduction about the general about the microorganisms and their role and importance in context to the fruits and vegetables. Then as I mentioned, that the controlling the growth of the microorganisms is the major focal in the preservation courses. Now in this, the second aspect will be how to control the microorganisms. That is, what is the concept, how to determine that what is their thermal death point, the curve. So those aspects will be covered. Then there are three main methods of controlling. One is the thermal control of microorganisms, then drying, then chemical methods of chemical. So all those aspects will be covered into the block 2 of the course, that is controlling microorganism. Then we know the food poisoning. So block 3 covers about the food poisoning, and it will be covering foodborne diseases, food intoxications, and food infections. And the last core block will be the safe chemical and microbial limit for different foods. What are the chemical limits and what are the microbial limits for the safe aspects. So this food microbiological course, it primarily gives the that what is the habitat of the microorganisms according to the core of the fruit and vegetable, what is the microbiological action in relation to spoilage of food and food products, what are the different methods of physical, chemical and biological methods of destruction of microorganisms in food, and what are the methods of microorganism, the microbiological examination of the foods, and what are the quality control norms for these things. So this aspect will be covered in the food and microbiology program. Now I will request Dr. Khodia to give more details about the course number 6, that is food processing and engineering.
Up to the 4 courses, they are supposed to be for the certificate course, another 4 courses a modular system to make a diploma program. So there it is a higher level in the same aspect also. So this food processing and engineering 2, that give little details about the how the processing aspect takes place and what the engineering aspect, which is very essential in order to maintain this quality during processing, during packaging, storage, distribution, until it reaches into hands of the consumers. So again we have here about 5 blocks. The first block deals with the food preservation by application of heat. As you know, there are several methods, but the heat application is very earliest method and started from 1920, and so for the what of the application of the heat, the principal heat and mass transfer, little engineering aspect, then heat applications. Under heat applications, how heat is applied, steam or hot water, to preserve these fruit and vegetable products. Then canning of fruit and vegetables is a commercial practice under which the fruit and vegetables are preserved by application of heat, and they can be preserved for quite a long time, say about 2 to 3 years. Block 2 deals with the food preservation through water removal. If they remove the water, because water is essential for microorganisms and for chemical reactions, so if we limit the quantum of the water in the fruit and vegetables, they can be preserved for longer durations, and it is a very earliest method we are waiting for longer use. And here the two, what are the form, how the water activity that control the spoilage organisms, especially microorganisms, that is a bacteria, yeast and fungi. Then drying, dehydration, evaporation, how this takes place, methodology, mechanism, that will be taken under this block. The block 3 deals with the food preservation and radiations, that with the chilling, how the low temperature refrigeration that affect the quality of the fruit and vegetables during storage, distribution, then control atmosphere. Now the latest technology has come where you can control the atmosphere in terms of oxygen, nitrogen and carbon dioxide. So the respiration is restricted and they can be prolonged as a fresh storage. Then food preserved by irradiations. I think number of the countries which has been permitted the use of irradiation, especially in the wheat, potato and onion. So the technology and advancement has taken place, that will be dealt under this unit. Block 4, we deal with the product utilization. After making this food processed product, there I'll find some types of the product remains there in the processing units. So how best they can be utilized, what are the type of the byproducts, juices or tidbits or skin or other things they can be make best used. Utilization of the food, the industrial use that can be made also, this one. Then food fortification. Now sometimes you will find the fruit and vegetables, they are resource of vitamins, minerals, water, fibers, but not of the protein and other things. So how they can fortify to enrich the protein and fight for the protein malnutrition. So this course will help them also. Then food packaging. Whatever the food is a packaging form, because it is easy to handle, easy to carry, easy to transport, easy to market and store. So this aspect is an essential aspect, and whole the quality of the processed product is depend upon the packaging aspect also. So they are the need of the importance, packaging material, packaging process and machinery, what are required, they should have some glimpses of this about food packaging.
Now I will talk about the course number 7. The food quality testing and evaluation is the 7th course. When we talk about the export, then the food quality becomes important. Otherwise also the quality is an important parameter. So this course will deal about the quality aspects, and in relation to this, this course has 3 blocks are there. The first block is about the quality. So this gives the that what is the quality, what are the quality attributes, what are the microbiological infections, so the all the quality specifications, so these are the aspects covered under the this. Then quality standardization, because in our country there are many laws are there, like PFA Act is there, food product order is there, vegetable oil regulations are there, milk and milk product order 92 is there, edible oil packaging order is there, ISI standards are there, egg mark standards are there, then codex standards are there, ISO standards are there, then even the weight and marketing department has also have the standards. Similarly, so what are the quality standards are there in our country, so those will be dealt in this course, in this block. Then the food safety management is an also an important part, that what are the good manufacturing practices, how do you control the hazard analysis critical control point system, HACCP system, then principles of HACCP, then total quality management, what are the basic tenets of total quality management. So these aspects will be covered under this course over there, this block. Then the next is the testing and evolution. Under this, we have the physical and chemical methods, and then we have the microbiological methods are there. Then sensory evolution is also there. So these are the three major units. What are the physical methods of grading the fruit and vegetables, raw as well as processed? Then there, what are the chemical microbiological tests, and what are the sensory evolution tests are there? So these will be taught to the students. Then we have a course on the block on the instrumentation, where some of the general instruments like pH meter, electronic balance, then paper chromatography, thin layer chromatography, then some of the equipment which are slightly sophisticated using spectroscopy, atomic spectroscopy, atomic absorption and emission spectroscopy, refractometer, polarimeter. So these aspects will be also covered. So this course number 7 is mainly trained to the students that how to do the quality control of the fruits and vegetables. And now I will request Dr. Khodia to give more details about the course number 8 on entrepreneurship and marketing course, please.
After knowing all the production of the processed products, the quality produced, packaging, and when the material is ready for marketing, the students should have the knowledge how to do the marketing, what are the entrepreneurship and marketing requirements. That is also essential aspect. Otherwise, they will remain in the godown or remain in the processing plant and which cannot be marketed. And this is reached into hands of the consumer and marketing agencies in the market, then it will be made available to them. So under this course of the entrepreneurship and marketing, the students will learn the skill how to they become entrepreneurs and how to do marketing for the better profit and for quality produce and sending this produce to the market and finally to the consumers also. So there are 5 blocks in this course. First block is the entrepreneur and entrepreneurship. How to become an entrepreneur, what does it involve, what are the entrepreneur skills, and how to develop the entrepreneur skills. These are the aspects are covered under this block. The next block is the setting up of an enterprise. When has to start a business, how to start the business, what is the business related to the food specially, because the food is an essential item, essential commodities, and anybody cannot do it unless they have some knowledge about the food, about the market, how to best keep its quality during distribution, storage. So they should have the business idea, how to get it, then market assessment, what is the market, what does marketing involve. All this aspect will be covered under this block of the setting of an enterprise. Then block 3 deal with the planning for the enterprise. How to plan this enterprise? What are the preparations to make a business plan? How to arrange the finances to get for the producing, for selling, for retailing, all this aspect, for transporting? Then understand the components for marketing mix. What are the mixed type of marketing? So they are producing all these things. They should plan the enterprise, and will all be aspect will be covered under this block. Block 4 dealing with the marketing management of the enterprise. How to management the production, what are the production considerations, what are the setting about the prices, how to set the prices, how to get the profit, how to pay the interest loan, all these things aspect. And then developing and managing distribution, understanding the managing promotion, how to promote the business, all aspect related to the marketing management will be considered under this block. This next block deals with the assessing performance. Whether we have done marketing, business, entrepreneur skill, arrangements, and earned the profit, paid the interest, all has to be assessed. Whether it is successful or failure, and what are the shortcomings, what are the success consideration criteria, they will be considered under this performance measurement and control, then managing growth. Because market is only not a standstill, it has to be further growth has to be made, increases the production, increases sale, like that also. International market scope are small enterprises, how the small enterprises can get together, produce this and sell it for the export market. So all aspect will be considered under this entrepreneurship also. Beside this 8 courses for the diploma program, we have certain audiovisual also adds, so they can give a student a ready-made hand to understand the whole of the course. There are about 15 audiovisual titles are there, and they will depict the pictures, depict the handling, depict it, say, how to manage all these things, about the raw materials, sloshes, how to prevent them, what are the nutrition aspect which are made available by the fruit and vegetable, storage structure, primary minimal processing, preparation of the wine and vinegar, effluent treatment of the fruit and processing plant, plant layout, equipment, production of value-added products from mango and other products, prevention and control of microbial spoilage, aseptic processing, canning fruit and vegetable, which are the commercial aspect of the processing, brought to the students at home, various reside also. The simple method of detection of adulterants found in processed product, laboratory facilities for quality evaluation of processed product, success story so they can learn the lesson and do proper marketing, and then packaging, which is a tool for marketing, and all this aspect will be covered under this thing also.
I think, Dr. Khodia, we should also tell them that this course have 50% will have the practical component, and for the practical components, the study centers will be all the KVKs, are the food processing centers, are the fruit and vegetable centers, which has been established by Ministry of Food Processing, are fruit and the institutions which are giving food and technology degree program. So those institutions will be selected, and where the students will be given training, hands-on training for these type of products preparation will be there. Anything more you want to add up before we conclude, Dr. Khodia, please?
I think that all the aspect has been covered about the courses, theory courses, practicals, and audiovisuals, and the counselor will be there in the study center. They will help to clear their doubt, their any questions are there, they will be done, and practicals are made where the laboratories, established laboratory, so they will get the first hand information, and they can be self-sufficient also.
So we if there are any queries, question, response, there is no response. We thank to the Dr. Khodia for giving a good outlook to the new program which is being developed, and I think there will be good response to the program, and we will giving now we'll be dealing more about the what are the components of the courses in some of our further teleconferencing sessions. Thank you.
Thank you.